So Bartley.
Yes. Bartley.
Powerful, strong coach, antagonist at times. Talk about what you tried to bring to this character in terms of representing what it meant to be a black man at that time in business.
Well, Bartley was just so fun, you know, to play and to portray, I guess I should say. Because, you know, he was a combination of, like, P.T. Barnum and Don King at the same time, you know. And, you know, in the early 1900s, this is amazing, you know, for an African American to exist, you know, with so much chutzpah that he had, you know. I mean, he had his own weather balloon, you know. Who had their own weather balloon in the 1900s?
Which he pushed Buddy out of.
You're right.
That was an amazing scene, by the way.
So fun, yeah. You know. But it was actually true. It's something that Bartley actually done himself in order to promote, you know, his own interests. He would jump out of his hot air balloons. I don't know how he got the balloons back, but, you know, he would jump out of them. So, you know, it was just an extension of something he'd already done. But the fact that he was just a showman, you know, he just... producer, just anything that would bring in, that the public was interested in, you know, he just promoted. And the music was one thing, you know, he just saw what Bolden's music was doing to the people, and how it was bringing them out of this doldrum and into a sense of vice, you know, and he wanted to capitalize on that as a promoter and an entrepreneur would do. So he manages Bolden, and, you know, they do great things until they're considered threatened. And once they're considered threatened, you know, then things have to change. So.
And I think there's so many people who will hear that storyline and it resonates today, right?
Yes.
Because we've been talking about black ownership, black creativity, mm-hmm. even the late great Nipsey Hussle, the fact that he owned his masters.
Right.
People are saying that it matters for us to have oversight over our own creativity. What do you think about that right now, particularly as an actor, but just this idea of black community, entrepreneurship, and ownership?
Well, it exists, right? And it's very important. And I think it still continues. It's always continued, you know? It's always been there. I mean, you know, the economics of our people, you know, we've always been able to create an economic society. And I think once we get recognized for our success, you know, then... I think other entities come in and try and claim a piece of the pie, you know, and then maybe there's too many cooks in the kitchen, and then all of a sudden, you know, it ends up in a place where it didn't really begin. But we've always been a part of the economic history of this country. If not, like, just plain old built this country, right. You know?
From the ground up, just in case anybody forgot.
Right, yeah. So, so it, you know, it's just another story. Another example of, you know, a black man that had extreme talent, you know, and that was a huge success in the early 1900s, you know, before anyone even knew he existed. So I'm glad that his story is coming out today, and I think people need to hear about it.
Yes, and the last thing I wanted to ask about with this was this idea of jazz, right? So we often think of jazz as just, it's fun, it's light, there's dancing, Duke Ellington,
right, yeah.
But there's a component of race as well, and defiance and disruption.
Mm-hmm.
Just very quickly, talk about how Bolden really highlights the racial dynamic in America, as well as the music.
Right, well, his music was just so important because, you know, it just... brought people out of a doldrum, you know? I mean, they were living life, but not really living life, you know? And then all of a sudden, you know, he comes up with these syncopated sounds, these different rhythms, and all of a sudden, you know, wow, you
it's
know.
It's an awakening.
It's an awakening. They want to get up. They want to move, you know? They want to go to the dance hall, and it moves them from this doldrum society into sort of like a vice, you know?
Yeah.
People want to get funky and, you know, the funky butt, you know?
Yeah.
And enjoy themselves, you know, and they start to become happier and start to become just more involved in their own communities. And that awakening of the community began to seem threatening, you know, to others in the community, pretty much like the Caucasian community or any other ethnic communities that were there. So he was very influential, and that's what music does. It's always been a part of our society, and it's always been a part of our culture. So
that's the power.
That's the power.